Hello everyone, it's Miss Joyce from the Euclid Library, and I'm here today. We're virtually starting our summer reading program. Dig deeper, read, investigate, and discover. So you can log into our website to sign up for summer reading through our Beanstack. And if you have questions, you can always call and ask. We are doing the Lobby's only is open for pickups if you order some materials, but you can always call or email us and we can answer any questions and concerns you have. But I want to do a story time today to get us started. So let us start with a little rhyme to get us going. If we wiggle our fingers and wiggle our toes, wiggle our shoulders and wiggle our nose, wiggle those fingers way up high and then wiggle them way down low, shake them fast and shake them slow. Now my wiggles are all out of me and I'm as happy as can be because it's story time. So today I want to do some stories about bugs. So the first one I want to read is a fun one called The Very Impatient Caterpillar by Ross Burach and by published by Scholastic. So here we start. The Very Impatient Caterpillar. Hey, what are you guys doing? We're gonna metamorphosize. Meta what? Now, transform into butterflies. Right, I knew that. Wait, you're telling me I can become a butterfly? Yes. With wings? Yes. For real? Yes. Wait for me. Now what? You build your chrysalis. Chrysalis? Right, I knew that. What? How do you do that? Is it a spin or more of a twirl? Am I a butterfly yet? Ugh. Now what? Just be patient and let nature take its course. Patience. Right. I got this. It's hard to be patient, isn't it? Am I a butterfly yet?
Nope.
How about now?
No.
Now? No. Be patient. I have a question. Not yet. You don't even know what I was gonna ask. Fine, ask. How's your day going? Also, am I a butterfly yet? No, just be patient. Shh, we're trying to metamorphosize. Okay. Obviously, I know this, but do you know how long it takes? 2 weeks. Right, 2 weeks. 2 weeks? What am I going to do in here for 2 weeks? Can I get a comic book or something? What if I need to go to the bathroom? Anyone want to play a game? What if I want a snack? Hello, 2 pizzas, please. My address, a chrysalis. Click. Hello. How long have I been in here? It's still day one? This is taking forever. That's it. I feel metamorphosized enough. Look out, world, feast your eyes on this beautiful butterfly. How do I look? Transformed? Time to spread my wings and fly? I don't think so. Wait, where are my wings? Splat. Time for a new approach. Okay, you can do this. You can be patient. Oh, who am I kidding? I can't be patient. Get a grip, you can. I can't. You are the little caterpillar that could. I'm the little caterpillar that couldn't. You can't. All right, so we have our days. Day one, I can be patient. Day two, patience is all in the mind. Day three, be one with the chrysalis. Day four, deep breathe in. Day five and out. Day six, look, day six. Day seven, I'm doing it. Day eight, and just be patient. Day nine, just be patient. 10, 11, 2 weeks later, I did it. I'm a butterfly. You know, I do feel transformed. Starting now, I'm going to be way more patient. That's great. Hey, what are you all doing? We're migrating. Migrating? Right. Wait for me. Are we there yet? and that's the end of the very impatient caterpillar. So it would be fun to be a butterfly, wouldn't it? You could be a caterpillar just like this and build that chrysalis and transform yourself into a beautiful butterfly to fly away. All right, so let's do a little rhyme with our about some butterflies. So we are going to pull out some butterflies that I have for you. So let's count them as we go along. Here we have one and two and three and four and five and six. And we have our different colors also. How about you see the purple one over here? And then we have, what color is this one? Orange and blue, yellow color, green and red. The first one to come to the garden bed is the lovely butterfly, a brilliant red. Then comes another, and that makes two. Fly right in. Here's our friend of blue. This garden is fine, the best I've seen, says the butterfly of softest green. Our garden needs a sunny fellow. Fly right in on butterfly wings of yellow. Little friend of purple, fly in too. The garden is waiting just for a color like you. Orange, 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 you've waited too long. Fly right in where you belong. Butterfly, butterflies, you're such a sight. Flying together, what a delight. There's our beautiful butterflies. So let's try a little rhyme to pretend we are butterflies, okay? So we're just gonna pretend that we are two little butterflies, one named Jack and one named Jill. Ready to act this one out? All right, so two little butterflies sitting on the hill, one named Jack and one named Jill. Fly away, Jack, fly away, Jill. Come back, Jack, and come back, Jill. All right, let's do another one, ready? Two little butterflies sitting on a cloud, one named Soft and one named Loud. Fly away, Soft, fly away, Loud. Come back, Soft, and come back, Loud. All right, good job. Two little butterflies sitting on a stick. One named Slow and one named Quick. Fly away, Slow. Fly away, Quick. Come back, Slow, and come back, Quick. Two little butterflies flying in the sky. One named Low and one named High. Fly away, Low. Fly away, High. Come back, Low. And come back high. Good job. All right. Nice, nice. All right. So now we did that. I think we should try to do a song. We're going to do a song about in the meadow. And this song is by Lori Berkner. And we have some different animals in the meadow. And we're going to count them as we go along. So we have a turtle. And then we have a fish. And do we know what this guy is? Our owl. And this is our little mouse. And our bee. All right, so the turtle is gonna dig. Let's see everybody dig. And then the fish goes swimming. And the owl, what's an owl say? Hoot, hoot, hoot. And then we have a mouse go squeak, 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 squeak. And a bee says bzzz. All right, so let's go along with the song.
Over in the meadow, in the sand, in the sun, lived an old mother turtle and her little turtle one. too, and they swam all day where the stream runs blue.
Jump right back down into your seat.
All right, yeah, have a seat back down. I have another story to share. This one is called Bugs, Bugs, Bugs by Bob Barner and published by Chronicle Books. This one you can we can also download from our website. It's available as a download that you can view too. So, lots of different bugs you can go out and see. So, bugs, 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 I want to see bugs. Butterflies that flutter in the sky. Spotted ladybugs that go creeping by. Long, friendly, long daddy long legs that never bite. Grasshoppers hop, hop, hopping out of sight. A fuzzy caterpillar with tiny feet. Bees buzzing by flowers that smell so sweet. A long line of ants that work so much. Roly-poly bugs that curl up when you touch. Bugs, 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 I can see buggy bugs all around me. And here's showing the actual size of the bugs. And then there's a page also that tells you different things about, such as, can it fly? Where does it live? How many legs? Does it sting? So you can learn all about the different kinds of bugs. I also brought some of our puppets to show you in case you get a... These are not realistic sizes though, but as you can tell by here's my bee, bees are not this big. If they were, it would be pretty scary. So we have our bee and then a grasshopper. You have to look closely in the grass for those and they jump pretty high. And here's what the grasshopper looks like. Okay, and then another thing to keep looking out for would be the ladybug. We do see quite a few of those. They fly around, but they're pretty teeny, like the bees. And then ants. This ant is huge. We certainly don't want to find an ant that is this big. But there are some teeny, teeny little ants, and then there's some larger ants. But we certainly want them to be small and outside. And then we also have a caterpillar. Here's our fuzzy little caterpillar. He's such a little cutie. And also the daddy long legs is here. Anybody know how many legs the spider has? 8 legs. Good answer. Yep, 8 legs. And then I do not have a roly-poly bug. So I can't show you what those, but they are tiny, very, very tiny. And they definitely curl up when they get scared. And then we have a butterfly, which is what our stories have been about. So there you go, some bugs you can look for outside. And like I said, if you want to try to download this, and then you could even find out some more information about the bugs. So there you go. And then I had one other story I wanted to share, because I put my bugs away so I don't trip. The other one that I want to share is published by Scholastic with permission, and it is called Big Bugs, Giant Creepy Crawly Pop-Ups, and it's by Keith Faulkner. And this one I want you to think about before I show you the page to give it away. What kind of bug is big, is yellow and black, I'm sorry, it's not big, yellow and black, lives in a hive, and has wings on its back? Do we know what kind of bug that would be that would have wings on its back and live in a hive? Did you guess the bee? Yes, there's our honeybee. All right. And then this one, what kind of bug is red and shiny with round black spots that are very tiny? We just talked about that one too. Did you guess that one? There's our ladybug. Good job. All right, and then what kind of bug lives in the ground, builds dirt hills, and has friends all around? Remember I said they aren't as big as what we had? It is, this one's pretty big too though, an ant. They're really not that big though. And what kind of bug noisily sings by rubbing together two of its wings? That one's a little harder. Do you know which kind makes noise? It's a cricket. And then, what kind of bug has wings that are bright and help take it on a very long flight? That's the one we've been talking about. That is the butterfly. Nice. All right. Good job. So, those are the rhymes I had for today and the stories I wanted to share. Just a reminder, so we do have another story time this afternoon at 2:30 to help kick off our summer reading program. And through the month of June, we will do story times on Tuesdays at 10:30, 2:30, and 6:30. So we're hoping you can join us for any of them, all of them. Come join us. It's all virtual, so it's something to get used to, but we're doing the best we can, and we're hoping you're enjoying it. And don't forget to look into our summer reading, join in, check our website, click on the Beanstack link, and you'll be all set and good to go. So it was great to see you. Hope to see you again, and happy summer reading.